Hello and welcome to my YouTube channel. Today we are going to learn about IR double beam spectrometer. You can see a figure is given on screen. The instrument looks like that from outside. But inside, actually, what are the components? How we are getting this graph? And what is the instrumentation that we have to learn today? So, just we are going to start the IR double beam spectrometer. Yes, so these are the basic component for IR double beam spectrometer. Radiation source. In IR instrument, we are using infrared frequency. For that purpose, we must have a source which can provide the infrared frequencies. So the radiation source is the key point for infrared spectroscopy. Now, second is absorption cell, or you can say sample cell. Sample cell is why known as absorption cell, because a substance which is going to absorb will be put in the cell. Next, monochromator. Monochromator is a device which converting polychromatic light into the monochromatic light. Mirrors, some rotating mirror, detector, amplifier, and recorder. So these are the component which included in the IR double beam spectrometer. Now we are going to see the schematic diagram. Yes, this is a schematic diagram for the IR double beam spectrometer. And after seeing this figure, if we are seeing this figure first time, it may surprising for us how, when it starts and where it starts. So we are going to make very simplified it. First, we will simplify the figure and we will understand the complete mechanism in this figure only. And then we will see each and every component in details one by one. So we are starting from the filament. This filament is the source for the infrared region frequencies. Filament is a source for IR frequency. And now when the filament generates the IR frequency, it passes in each and every direction, but we focus on two part. One frequency is going in this way, another going in this way, and here a mirror is putted, so it will get reflected. The reflected ray will go in this side, another reflected ray will go this side. Starting from the filament, after reflection, it comes here, another mirror over here, another mirror over here also. So this is a mirror. It will get reflected from the mirror and entering into the solvent cell. Here it is entering into the sample cell. So now it is very important to know what is the solvent cell and what is the sample cell. See, in titration, we are making sometime blank reading without the sample. Same way here, if you take the solvent and put in black sample cell, that is solvent cell. And if you take a sample dissolved in solvent, that is sample cell. You may, if you don't have the solvent, you can put empty as sample cell and empty as solvent cell, and you can take sample in the sample cell. Now, after passing through the sample, thus ray will come on this direction after reflecting from this mirror. Same way, upper side also a mirror is there. The radiations coming through the solvent cell come here. Now, here at this point, they both may come together. But we put a device called a rotating mirror. What is the role of rotating mirror? The rotating mirror allows to pass the rays or radiations alternatively, means one time sample cell, another time solvent cell, alternatively, continuously, right? So these alternative rays will come here, and a mirror is also here, which make the reflection over here, and it passes through a prism. You can see this is not a simple prism, it is monochromatic device. And the radiation will further go to another mirror, get reflected, pass through the prism, again come to the mirror, and then going to the detector. So this part is detector part. Now, after detection, here the name of detector is written thermocouple. Much more detectors are also used in this IR double beam spectrometer. We are going to see each and every detector in full details in this video later. But here the rays are coming to the detector. Detector is detecting, then going to the amplifier, and the spectra will be recorded at the recorder. So this is the basic mechanism of IR double beam spectrometer. Now we have to think about the components in detail. We have to know about the component in each and every part of details of the component. Now, first we have to think filament we are using, right? We are using simple lights, lamps in our house, but we cannot use for IR because we require specific frequencies. And normal light source like lamp, tube light, they are giving random lights, okay, which all the regions are not usable for us. We required specific. So we are going to learn now which type of filament and what component are used in this instrumentation. So first thing, radiation source. The key point, radiation source. So normally in IR spectrometer, we observe three type of source of radiations. In that, the first one is ceramic rod. Ceramic rod made up of silicon carbide, which is also known as glow bar. So this is the first source. Small ceramic rod heated electrically at 1100 to 1800 Celsius for getting the desired frequencies. Then this is the first source. Now second one, Nernst filament. What is Nernst filament? A high resistance brittle element composed of a mixture of sintered oxide of zirconium, thorium, cerium held together by a binding material. Means these three elements, oxides, sintered oxide mixture held together by help of a binding material, and this creates a filament which used as named as Nernst filament. So this is the second source for IR instrument. And the third source, various type of other ceramic material. See, as we seen upper side, silicon carbide is there, but other ceramic materials are also used for preparation of filament, means IR source, right? Now, we are going to see the radiation is divided into two beams. As we seen in the instrumentation, the radiations are separating into two parts and get reflected from both the parts, right? So one which passes through the sample, another function as reference beam is which is blank. Now the reference and sample beams are then passed alternatively into the monochromator at very short interval by means of a rotating mirror. So here rotating mirror is doing what? Passing the both the beams alternatively at very short time intervals. And next is absorption cell. Absorption cell must be made up of either rock salt or potassium bromide. We cannot use the sample cell in IR with glass or quartz. Why? Some examination, some VIVAS, a question may be asked, why we are not using glass and quartz as a absorption cell in IR spectrometer? So answer is they are unsuitable because they absorb the IR radiation. If they absorb the IR radiation, we cannot get the desired graph. Some other peaks will also appear due to the glass and quartz. So it is not possible to use them. Now next, sample preparation. Sample preparation can be done by 0.55 milligram sample of your substance. May be examined in three ways. This sample can be examined in three ways. First, if the compound is soluble, take 0.55 milligram, take in solvent carbon tetrachloride or chloroform or carbon disulfide, prepare a liquid film and take for the sample. In case of some solid which are not sufficiently soluble in the solvent, can be taken for the MUL technique. What is MUL technique? In MUL technique, you have a MUL and you are adding a Neujol. Neujol is a white mineral oil and it possesses some hydrocarbons. Or as a pellet, if you have a solid sample, you can directly take the solid sample, take KBR dry powder, mix it well and press in hydraulic pressure. So there are three options. If the compound is soluble in solvent, prepare by solvent. If partially soluble or not completely soluble, go for Neujol MUL technique. If it is not suitable, then go for directly solid sample. So three ways for sample preparation. For measurement in solution, identical absorption cells are used and this reference beam passes through one of these containing pure solvent. Next, monochromator. The pulse beam enters into the monochromator through an entrance slit, is dispersed by grating, or you can say the prism, whatever we wrote in our schematic diagram, it may be grating or it may be a Littor mount prism. Littor mount prism, which is a specific type of prism. In the monochromator, the emergent beams are sorted out into individual wavelengths by means of sodium chloride prism, which is transparent to infrared throughout the 4000 to 650 centimeter inverse. So sodium chloride prism is suitable for most of the IR range. Okay, but if you want to go for 650 below, means 650 centimeter inverse below, you have to use potassium bromide prism, which is transparent up to 400 centimeter inverse. And if you want to go for less than 400 centimeter inverse, you have to use the prism made up of cesium iodide, which is transparent up to 200 centimeter inverse, right? So that can be employed. So which range you going to work out, on basis of that, you can choose the monochromators. Next, the types of detector. As I told earlier, so many types of detector are used. Out of that, here, one by one, we will see total six type of detectors are there. So we will see one by one. The first one is bolometer. Second one is thermocouple. Third one is Golle. Fourth one is pyroelectric. Fifth one is photoconductor, or you can call also photodiode. Sixth one, photoconductor, or you can call as photovoltaic or photoelectric. Now we will see each and every one by one why and which one can be used at where. So the bolometer is doing the measurement in basis of resistance, and the construction of bolometer detector is done by platinum nickel combination. And the operating frequency, operating spectral region for bolometer detector is 4000 to 400 centimeter inverse, which is suitable normal instruments, right? Second one, thermocouple. Thermocouple measures on basis of thermoelectrical effect, and the made up construction of the thermocouple detector is by bismuth and antimony. And the region as same above, 4000 to 400 centimeter inverse. Now the third one is Golle detector. Thermal expansion is the key factor on base which it do the measurement of the higher frequencies, and the construction is pneumatic cell. Spectral region looking for that is same 4000 to 400 centimeter inverse. Pyroelectric detector measures on basis of capacitance, and the construction of this detector is done by triglycerin sulfate. The range for that is middle IR range. Next one, photoconductor detector, or you can say photodiode detector. It is working on the measurement of resistivity. And you can see there are four options. There are four options. If it is made up of PBS, lead sulfide, it can be used for this range. If it is made up of lead selenium, it can be used for this range. If it is made up of indium antimony, it can be used for 5000 to 1616. And if it is made up of this three combination, mercury, cadmium, and tellurium, it can be used to 5000 to 525 centimeter inverse. So different makes give the different frequency for operation, right? And last, photoconductor, you can say photovoltaic, which works on the reaction of photons. Indium, gallium, arsenide. It is the operating frequency 24,287 to 5582 centimeter inverse. Same way, indium arsenide 10,000 to 3,226. And indium antimony 10,000 to 1,818 centimeter inverse. So these are the main points of the detector, highlights of the detector. Now we are going to see one by one in detail. Yeah. The detector, the pulsating single beam now emerging through the exit slit is a narrow band and consisting only very few frequencies. It means what? Few frequencies mean the filtered frequency from the prism, or you can say monochromator, now going to enter into the detector. Okay, so filtered beam is coming now from the monochromator. And after this dispersion, the beams are focused alternatively at with particular wavelength throughout the spectral range by means of a mirror system onto the detector. Normally, in normal instruments, we are observing mainly two detector. One is thermocouple and another is photovoltaic. But we will see one by one, each and every. So here the first detector is thermocouple detector. See, thermocouple detector. This detector consists of several thermocouples connected in series so that their outcomes are added together for greater sensitivity, and a thermocouple detector works on the principle that wires of two dissimilar metals. See, thermocouple is made up of two dissimilar, means not similar metal. Example, one bismuth, another antimony. So both are the different metal. And now it works on the base of head and tail. Head and tail. So then the difference in the temperature between head and tail causes a current flow in the wire. And in IR spectrometer, this current will be proportional to the intensity of the radiation falling on the thermocouple detector. What is the basic principle of thermocouple detector? When the radiation beam, which coming from the monochromator, passes through the thermocouple detector into the head and tail, the interaction of the radiation will change some temperature. Okay, and this will cause the spectrum detection. So this is the key principle for the this detector. Now second, Golesel detector. This consists of a glass filled enclosure with a diaphragm and extends on IR radiation and give a change in the signal due to the amount of movement on the diaphragm. So this Gole is working on the diaphragm principle. Next, photovoltaic detector. Now photovoltaic detector uses a diode type device based on doped silicon or indium antimonide material, or it may be made up of indium gallium arsenide. So this is doped material and diode is made up of that. And next is pyroelectric detector. See, the pyroelectric detector is made from single crystalline wafer of triglycerin sulfate sandwiched between two electrodes. It means between two electrodes, a wafer-like single crystalline triglycerin sulfate is put as a sandwich model, and when the electric field is applied, the field is removed and the polarization persists due to the electrical field once applied. It is temperature dependent and semiconductor act as a conductor. Semiconductor will act as a capacitor, right? And the incident infrared heating causes a change in the capacitance of the material, and the pyroelectric effect depends on the rate of the change of the detector temperature and not on the temperature of itself, but which allows for faster response time. So pyroelectric detector working on the principle of this way. Pyroelectric detector are used in mid-infrared region, work at room temperature, and applied in most of the FTIR instruments. Photoelectric detector, the mercury cadmium telluride detector, comprises a film of semiconducting material deposited on a glass surface and sealed in the evacuated envelope. So this is the preparation, how it prepared. And absorption of IR promotes non-conducting valence electron to a high conducting state, and the electrical resistance of semiconductor decreases. So these detectors have better response characteristics than pyroelectric detectors, are used in FTIR instrument. particularly in combination with instruments such as GC, FT, IR. So some of the instruments are combinative instrument. You may heard about FT, IR with GC, GC with MS, etc. MS means mass spectrometry. And the last part of this instrumentation, amplifier and recorder. So amplifier and recorder is doing what? When we get the signal from the detector, the amplifier will do the amplification of the signal electronically and by means of mechanical arrangement. The spectrum, which is really a measure of difference in the intensities of reference and sample beam throughout the wavelength range, is recorded by the recorder as a special graph paper mounted on the rotating drum. So by this way, the graph will be recorded, amplified by the amplifier, and then will get recorded by the recorder in the form of IR spectrum. So this is all about the double beam IR spectrophotometer, or you can say IR double beam spectrophotometer. Thank you for watching. If you like this video, please like in YouTube and subscribe my channel. If not subscribe, and give your comments. Thank you.